Hello students, let's move on with part 2 of chapter 10. In this chapter and in this part, we will learn basic terminology of the internet. So, the few words that are repeatedly used while we will talk about the internet. The first word is web page. Now, what is this web page? The information is put on the internet in the form of digital pages. And these digital pages are called the web page. These pages may contain text, graphics, video, audio, and links to other pages. So the collection of all these things will be the web page. Now the next term is website. The information available on the internet is given in websites and on web pages. As a book contains a number of pages, similarly, a website is a collection of related web pages linked with one another. So, the collection of web pages will become a website. Now, the next term is home page. Now, what is this home page? The main page of any website that contains links to other pages is called the home page. By default, it is the first page of every website. So whenever you are surfing and you are opening any website, the first page that will open will be the home page. Now the next term is web browser. A web browser is a software, application or program that allows you to access the entire information available on the web. So if you want to use the internet, you need a web browser. You can normally open your web browser from a shortcut on your desktop. Browsers make it very easy to move from one website to another. You can visit any website by entering its URL in the address bar of a web browser. So if you want to open any website, just type its name in the address bar. Examples of some popular web browsers are Internet Explorer, Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox, Opera, etc. So these are few web browsers by using which you can access the internet. Now let's see the next term, that is search engine. A search engine is a software that searches for any information required by the user. The first very well known search engine is Google. The internet searches various web pages on the World Wide Web, that is www. Now, some of the most popular search engines are Google, Bing, Yahoo, etc. Out of which Google is we all are using frequently. Now, the next term is URL. To visit your friend's place, you need to know his or her house address. Yes or no? Similarly, to visit any website, you need to know its address. Each website is identified by its unique address, which is known as the Uniform Resource Locator, that is URL. URL should be entered in the address bar of a web browser to visit the website. For example, if you want to search for Cartoon Network website, just type the name www.cartoonnetwork.com, or else you can also type Discovery Channel, that is www.discoverychannel.com, in the address bar of the web browser and press the enter. Now let's see how to connect to the internet. So there are many more options available by using that you can connect to the internet. Before that, let's know the fact. www.bing.com is the latest search engine from Microsoft. So which is the latest search engine? That is Bing. Now let's see connecting to the internet. There are various ways to connect to your computer with the internet. Let's see one by one. The first method is dial-up connection. So what will be there in dial-up connection? In dial-up connection, a telephone line is connected to a modem, which is in turn connected to a computer. So for the dial-up connection, you require a telephone line. The modem receives the signal over the phone line from the sender computer and then translates the signal to the receiving end. So here the modem also required. The dial-up connection works only when you connect your computer with the modem, as shown in figure. Now the next method is DSL connection. Now what is this DSL? DSL stands for Digital Subscriber Line. This connection uses a dual phone line, as shown in figure. You can connect to the internet using one line while the other line is free for calling. You need not dial a phone number in order to connect to the internet. It offers a speed between 128 kbps and 8 mbps. Okay, so the speed is also good. It is an internet connection that is always on. So this is about the DSL, Digital Subscriber Line, as shown in figure. It is also having a DSL modem. Now let's see the next one, that is cable connection. The cable connection that is used to connect a computer to the internet uses the same wiring as is used for a TV connection. As the cable TV has limited coverage for only up to a certain part of the city, the remote areas thus may lack the access to the cable signal. Moreover, the increase in demand can affect the speed of the service. So, this is not good at all. Depends on the area that it covers. Now, let's see the satellite connection. You can connect your computer to the internet through a satellite connection in the similar manner that you used to connect to a satellite TV. The rural areas and the areas unreachable by wires can also get the connectivity by using the satellite connections. So this doesn't require any wiring. However, the connection may sometimes be interrupted due to bad weather conditions. So this is the drawback of the satellite connection. Now next we will see the next option, that is cellular connection. You can connect to the internet using wireless technology used in cell phones, that is mobile phones. The cell phones provide 3G, 4G speeds these days. Okay, now what is this 3G? 3G stands for third generation of mobile technology. It provides a speed of around 2 Mbps and 4G refers to the fourth generation that provides a speed of 100 Mbps or above. So I hope that how to connect to the internet is clear to you all. Here a part 2 ends. Thank you for watching my video.